those were our best shows. And when we varied from that, we made some mistakes, I think.
Mm-hmm. I think one fan comment we got during the third year quite often was, how come Captain Kirk gets a new girl every week?
Well, he uses up the old one.
Bill, I'm going to order some sound effects and see if you remember what they are.
Okay. Oh, I remember that one.
We're aboard the U.S. Enterprise.
Hey, there's my chair. I'm going to sit on it. Hold on a second, Jim.
Okay, you're there.
It still
fits. The bridge is around you.
Yes.
You are Captain Kirk.
I am Captain Kirk.
We've gone back to the 20th century, and you're Captain Kirk with this incredible power at your disposal.
Yes.
We have a world down there that Roddenberry and Shatner live on, which
yes.
is unfair, intolerable, full of violence, bias, and so on.
Yes.
What would you as Captain Kirk do to change this?
Let them suffer. I mean it. If they can't work out their problems, if Captain Kirk and the Enterprise has to solve their problems, we'll have to make frequent visits. Seriously. I think that the theory of non-interference, which is stated time to time in the Enterprise moving to new worlds, we must not interfere, is the anthropologist's credo of non-interference with life forms that they're observing. It's essential that some other life form, if it wants to keep the continuity of the life form that they're observing, not interfere.
20th century must solve its own problems.
That's right.
Sitting there saying that, I have to respond by saying, really, you are Captain Kirk.
You better believe it, Gene Roddenberry. And now, get off my bridge.
Scotty, ahead. Warp factor one.